you've got to master their way before suggesting yours. You can't get into work and you've been there 3 weeks and you want to change everything. You know, you see better ways of doing it and you're ready because that is not cool. So when you stay at an organization, you can't begin to make suggestions for months. You've got to be quiet and look at how things are done and get a lay of the land and begin to understand the culture. You've got to begin to understand the processes and how we communicate ideas and how we make changes. Because if you come in and try to make changes right off the bat, you're going to irritate Gen X right off the bat and the baby boomers. So you've got to begin to understand how you can be. Number two, you've got to be a sponge. You've got to be a sponge. You've got to learn how to absorb, how to listen, how to look, how to see how things get done. You've got to look and figure out how ideas are communicated before you start to make evaluations. And you have to invest in yourself before you expect us to invest in you. And what does that mean? That means learning products, understanding them, doing your homework at night, maybe volunteering to help with a conference, maybe giving a presentation. You've got to begin to step out of what's expected and do some things that are not expected in order to grow. If I see that you're investing time in you, I'm going to invest time in you. But if I don't see that, probably you're not going to get my time. So it's a two-way street. So we have to begin to look at our career and say, where can I give if I'm expecting things back? And you've got to be committed to your career and you have to be a strong ambassador of the brand. If you've got smart friends out there that you think would do well here, you've got to talk the company up and you've got to be an ambassador to the brand, okay? I believe that we all have biases from our experiences, from the way we were raised, from our parents, from the times, from technology. You begin to look at that, and sometimes we have to be more aware of those biases because I notice that millennials don't talk to me until they find out what I do, and then they want to do it. So I'm on a lot of airplanes and I don't get that eye contact. I don't get it. So it's a two-way street where we all have biases. So somehow we have to work through those and we have to begin to see people as people. And we have to see them and listen and ask questions and understand where they're coming from.